The setup is familiar, an assassin attempting to kill the US president up against an elite Secret Service agent, but both the main players are female. This movie is actually the second part of a trilogy, set between First Daughter and First Shot, but in this outing the central character Alex McGregor is played by Daryl Hannah and not Mariel Hemingway. A cabal of powerful businessmen are so unhappy with the president's policy decisions that they hire a particularly nasty and deadly woman to eliminate the problem. There's also a secondary plot about an extremist sending video threats, throwing a traitor or two within the Secret Service, a rookie agent desperate to prove herself, and an obvious last minute reveal that the vice president is involved, and it's a very familiar final product. However, this is a TV movie with decent production value, and Ona Grauer's ruthless hitwoman is a memorable villainess. Nina's introduction is the kind of scene any female villain aficionado should relish, a reveal of a sexy and highly skilled assassin with lots of promise.
What'd you do?
Nina probably could have taken this man without drugging his margarita, but this is someone with an ego who enjoys besting her opponent. Her confidence almost gets the better of her. So the stage is set for the main scheme to begin, with the assassin reporting to her client Hunter, and this is your typical shady money man who lives on a luxury estate and throws lavish parties. His interest in Nina goes beyond professional, but she regards her sexiness as a tool to seduce, manipulate and control. Her brother Evan is not best pleased with Hunter's attitude, and Nina is twisted enough to torment even him. This is all just foreplay before a weapons test, where Nina gets to demonstrate her sharp shooting skills.
The beauty of this piece is that once you set your range, the bullet will explode whether you hit your target or not. The bullet's at a maximum velocity of 100 meters. The hit will take place at that range.
Where'd you get that?
I built it through the internet. It's amazing what you can do with the right .coms.
Your brother's use of the information highway is very impressive.
We all have our addictions, don't we?
And it's clear that Nina's looking forward to blowing up the president in similar fashion. Another movie with a sniper martial artist villainess, this entry in the long-running sniper series has Brandon Beckett team up with his veteran father to uncover a corporate conspiracy. The pre-title sequence establishes Lady Death as a mysterious, calm and lethally efficient killer, someone able to assassinate a South American politician from a hotel room miles away. Before taking the shot, the female sniper plants her hair and saliva to frame Brandon Beckett as the shooter, and she also plans to stage a suicide as well, but the authorities arrest the suspect before that can happen. The assassin's employer is rather annoyed by this complication, so he hires a team of Russian mercenaries to attack the prisoner convoy. Lady Death is there as backup and proves to be a far more effective killer as she takes down the security team. But even with the fire support, the villains still screw things up and Brandon manages to escape. Beckett gets help from a mysterious government agent known as Zero and a female analyst, and these two aren't so quick to believe the obvious story and manage to uncover a plot to kill the politician to make money from a trade deal. The storyline and lead villain are as bland as they sound, and the final confrontation is anticlimactic. The highlight is a sniper duel in the forest between the Becketts and Lady Death. Government operatives are little more than cannon fodder, but the father and son team prove a match for the former Yakuza assassin. After a standoff in the woods with the snipers patiently scoping out the targets, shots are finally exchanged and Brandon gets the drop on the villainess.
Ah.
easy.
Now in custody, Lady Death agrees to cooperate with Zero and the Becketts to bring down the main villain, and she pretends to have captured the hero, but the bad guy doesn't fall for it and the redeemed sniper gets shot for a betrayal. Thankfully, Lady Death does survive, and the final scene has Zero recruit her for a special ops unit, so expect to see more of this woman in future sniper movies. Alex's first encounter with the assassin comes while scouting out a national park the president is due to attend. Here, Nina deliberately bumps into the heroine and even gives her a smile afterward, and it's this audacity which elevates the villainess to legendary status, and a technician flirting with Nina has no idea he's given a deadly assassin access to the park's Skytram system. And this allows Evan to hack and override the security, and Nina even plays the seductress with her brother, toying with his emotions.
Evan, it's all about seduction. Sensuality is a weapon. You need to embrace that. You never know when it could prove useful. Do you understand?
Alex is certainly up against it, especially with a crazed militiaman threat to deal with and a traitor on her own team. The man killed on the yacht took photographs of Nina without her knowledge, but the insider replaces the incriminating picture with a dummy one to throw Alex off the trail. When the president comes to give a speech at the national park, Nina takes position on a rooftop and prepares a rifle, and now has a clear shot at the target area. With the Skytram under Evan's control, the president is an easy target once he's on board the cable car and isolated from his secret service team. Fortunately, Alex has remembered Nina from before and identifies her as the shooter. Plus, she has help from her boyfriend Grant, who spent most of the movie attempting to propose to Alex, but now gets to play the hero.
Stay calm.
And while Alex deals with Evan, it's Grant's job to take on Nina. Well, at least Grant managed to save the president. Alex is now the only person who can expose the traitors and stop Nina from completing her contract, and the assassin swaps out a fancy rifle for more conventional weaponry as Alex tries to get the president to safety. And after a three-way tussle between the heroine president and traitor, Nina has a seemingly free shot at a target.